tomatoes tweak to produce vitamin D. Despite being offered free, the sunshine vitamin, vitamin D, is still an issue worldwide. Vitamin supplements are on the market to help those with deficiency. But will you be interested in fresh produce tweaked to be a source of vitamin D? That's what researchers did by turning tomatoes into a new source of this vitamin. The human body can synthesize many molecules, including vitamins. Yet our poor evolutionary design prevents us from easily producing vitamin D. For some reason, it involves a very complex pathway, though it should only need cholesterol, which we have a lot of. The cholesterol for vitamin D synthesis requires an activator, sunlight. When your skin is exposed to sunlight, the ultraviolet B energy activates the 7-dehydrocholesterol in the skin and converts it into vitamin D3. This is then delivered to the liver, where it picks up more oxygen and hydrogen. Here, it becomes 25-hydroxyvitamin D, and this is used by doctors to detect vitamin D deficiency, though this isn't usable by the body until processed in the kidneys. After visiting the kidneys, the substance gets the final pair of oxygen and hydrogen to form 1,25-dihydroxyvitamin D, or calcitriol, simply vitamin D for most people. At John Innes Center, researchers develop a new source of vitamin D via gene editing. They use a common food ingredient, tomato. They use gene editing to disable a specific molecule in the plant's genome to raise the provitamin D3 in the fruit itself and its leaves. Like how it works on human skin, the provitamin D3 form becomes vitamin D3 after exposure to UVB light. Tomato is the choice because it contains the building blocks of vitamin D. Yes, it has the same cholesterol mentioned earlier, but the levels aren't enough to accumulate in ripe tomato fruits. So, gene editing was done to boost that part, and one outcome was having edited tomato plant leaves with up to 600 micrograms of vitamin D3 per gram of dry weight. Researchers tested their tweaked tomato plants. They exposed the leaves and sliced fruit to UVB for an hour to determine the conversion. It was a success where the precursor cholesterol turned into vitamin D3. One tomato had levels equal to vitamin D in 2 medium-sized eggs or a 28-gram tuna. This approach may help address the global vitamin D deficiency, affecting 40% of Europeans and 1 billion people worldwide. Bringing vitamin D3 on the table allows people to get their daily uptake of vitamin D, especially those who live in areas with long colder months, when sunlight is weak. Do you spend time basking under the sun? Do you take vitamin D supplements instead? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.